Welcome back to Deep State. I'm Nick Hawks. This time we've got Karam Lakshman from Wi-Fi Dabba on. Super excited to get into the conversation with him. This episode is sponsored by Eclipse Labs. Eclipse is building Ethereum's fastest layer 2 powered by the Solana virtual machine. Eclipse combines Solana's performance and scalability with Ethereum security to get the best of both worlds. You can read more about Eclipse at www.eclipse.builders. We'll have a little bit more on them later in the show. Before we get started, make sure you hit the like, subscribe, and the bell. That helps us keep bringing rad guests like Karam onto you. Karam, thanks so much for making the time. I know you guys are super busy. Welcome to the show.
Awesome. Glad to be here. Long time listener, first time caller.
Love it. So we've been talking a while with this Wi-Fi Dabba thing. Full disclosure, Wi-Fi Dabba is a client of Goldhawks. So Max and I have been working with you for a while. We're super excited with what we're seeing so far and wanted to make sure that the rest of the DePIN world sees what's going on. So maybe let's start with what is Wi-Fi Dabba?
Sure. So Dabba is a marketplace building high-speed broadband Wi-Fi from the ground up in India. We're doing this because relative to the rest of the world, India is underserved in broadband connectivity. The US has about 112 million broadband connections. China has 650 million, and India only has about 30 million. So there's a long way to go. Using the principles of DePIN pioneered by Helium, our goal is to double the size of connectivity in India. That is to say, in the next 5 years, we want to be able to take India from 30 million connections to 60 million connections. We're going to do this by aggregating the over 150,000 micro ISPs that are already serving the market. These have a couple of hundred subscribers each, and our goal is to provide them all of the hardware, software support, and marketing support they may need to double the size of their existing base. The demand for data is exploding in India. It's nuts. From the latest Nokia report, data consumption has grown by more than 3.5x in the last 5 years. Average user consumption per month has doubled. And because it's a log scale, the way these things happen, the amount of data India consumes is going to double just next year alone. So our goal at the Dabba network is to build a decentralized marketplace that serves this new exploding demand in this emerging market that's got a ridiculous amount of room to go.
Love it. And we'll come back to this idea of marketplace because I think it's really important that it's not just a network, but it's an actual marketplace. But for you guys, I mean, this is you've been doing this Wi-Fi stuff for a while. Give me a little bit of background on how you guys came to start Wi-Fi Dabba and what you've been doing.
Sure. My co-founder, Shubs, and I have been running a software company for the last 15 years. We started Dabba in 2017. We raised money from Y Combinator and other great investors, and our goal was to bring low-cost connectivity in India. We've spent the last 7 years sort of doing everything that you can imagine to innovate at every step to lower the cost. For a couple of years, for example, we powered Google Wi-Fi in India. A lot of it was us underlying that network. So we worked on the hardware, the software, the local relationships, the government relationships, and the sort of entire user experience that it takes to deliver low-cost Wi-Fi at rock-bottom prices to a market that really needs it. This sort of is what has brought us to DePIN, and we think that almost the last 7 years of hard work has led us now to create this structure in this marketplace where we think we can dramatically scale this solution and help bring everyone on board and, yeah, build a really healthy connectivity scene in the country for the next 20, 30 years.
Yeah. Yeah, and super cool to see the kind of depth of experience that you guys bring to this. This isn't just a, like, hey, I found out about this last week and I'm going for it. This is, hey, this is, we've been doing this for a while. We've done this on a really professional level for a long time, and now we're going to use this DePIN thing to do to really accelerate it. So that's super exciting. Let's see, maybe we talk a little bit about how folks get rewarded on the Dabba network. I think that's a pretty interesting thing that you guys are doing as far as spreading out across the whole chain of basically the signal chain, how those rewards go. Can you walk me through that?
Sure. A really broad overview is we've spent the last sort of couple of months learning from all of the DePIN networks that have come before and sort of taking the best that we could from each one of the projects. And We've streamlined our reward system into something that we believe is fair for those that contribute connectivity to the network. So there are four key players and stakeholders of what it takes to deliver low-cost connectivity, right? The first is the hotspot owner, the person that buys the actual hotspot hardware. The second is the local cable operator or the micro ISP, the person that's actually installing the hardware at a location, maintaining it, making sure it's up good, making sure they've got the regulations in place and permission to install and that sort of thing. The third is the person that provides backhaul, which is the core connection to the internet itself, to that hotspot or to that operator. And the last is the location owner themselves. So we've got these four buckets, and we follow a very similar approach to the way Helium has taken things. We think it's a great model that's worked well and been proved out. Both the market likes it, people like it, and sort of the process of how it works as well. So we'd like to go with true and tested and stand on the shoulders of giants before we innovate further. So rewards are built around consumption of data and proof of coverage. It follows Helium very similarly. And if you have any experience with any other DePIN project, when you get a chance to look at our tokenomics, which comes out shortly, this should be very familiar to you.
Cool. Super cool. Yeah, it's been fun to work with you guys and Max on like, hey, what do we learn in Helium and how do we apply it to this to make it even better, which is a really, really cool thing. Now, let's talk about how this whole system across that signal chain, so LCOs, location owners, hardware owners, whatever it is, the backhaul side, how does that make this whole thing a pretty seamless process for the person buying a Daba Lite? So if you buy the hardware and the market and the installer's already in place, like walk me through how that makes it really easy for someone to deploy a Daba hotspot.
For sure. So our goal has been, again, learning from how other projects have handled things so far and trying to see if we can bring some contribution to making that process better. So the way that it works is you buy a Daba hotspot, go to the Daba Explorer. You will be able to see the different ISPs and all of the information associated with them. So you'll see the size of their network, the reliability of their network, customer reviews, their uptime, a little bit of video about them. Basically, we want to provide as much transparency and as much information as possible for you to pick who is the best party to deploy your hotspot in the best location. They will then deploy that hotspot within 24 hours and bam, your hotspot starts earning rewards, data consumption is paid for. And our goal over the course of the next year will be to bring that turnaround time even lower so that from the moment you buy a hotspot to your hotspot going live should be under a couple of hours at most.
Dang. That's amazing. I mean, and it's so much nicer for those of us who have been involved in these other networks. They've all been super fun, but a lot of us end up with a garage full of cables and antennas and all that other shit. And then you got to go deploy it yourself. This is a super cool way to make it so that you buy a hotspot and someone else installs it, takes care of all of that stuff. That makes for a really nice experience, at least on my end so far. We bought a Daba hotspot, kind of picked our thing and went through. It's like, oh, this is so much easier than setting up anything, any other mining rig. And it's cool to be a part of it in that way.
Yeah. Our goal is genuinely that. Speed and reliability above all.
Love it. Love it. Let's take a quick break and we'll talk about today's show sponsor, Eclipse Labs. One of the cool parts about doing this show is we get to talk tons of projects across the space, including back-end nerdy stuff that helps DePIN projects. One of those is today's show sponsor, Eclipse Labs, who's building Ethereum's fastest layer 2 to support several DePIN projects. Eclipse leverages the best parts of the modular stack, Solana for execution, Celestia for scalability, and Ethereum for security. Eclipse is committed to helping projects build on DePIN. Check them out at eclipse.builders and check out the interview we did with Neil at Eclipse if you haven't seen it yet. So coming back to this stuff, to Wi-Fi Dabacrom, if folks want to get a hotspot or want to check it out, let's just start with the easiest way. Like how do they sign up? How do they get the thing and jump in?
Yeah. So you can visit dabba.com. That's dabba.com. To check out the hotspot and see how everything works. The second thing that you can do is go to daba.network, and we've got a Git book up there that describes the India market, the story, how things are actually deployed. We're continuously editing and updating that. You can also join our Discord server, which is growing rapidly, and be part of an amazing community that's got some really good ideas and is excited to see where things are going.
Yeah. And it's, I mean, it's already in service. Like I said, Max and I had bought these things. You got a bunch of these out there. I don't know if you can share the numbers on who you're working with right now. I think it's a little bit early for that, but it just seems like we've already got this thing working. What's the kind of general launch time? I don't need a date, but we're not looking for, you know, not looking like, oh, it's going to be sometime in 2025.
Not at all. As I said, speed and reliability, right? So our goal is to launch pretty quick. We hope in the next month or two at most. We're working extraordinarily hard behind the scenes to make things happen as soon as possible. Very excited.
Yeah, you guys are crushing. And it's cool to see this thing built up as not just a network, but this idea of a marketplace. What is it, 150,000 ISPs across India? I think you're telling me. And if we unite them under one token, that's a pretty cool way to use this new technology and merge it with what has been happening so far. So super cool to see what's going on. Is there anything else before we wrap up that you're super psyched on with Daba? I know people are going to want to go buy one and check it out, but anything else you want to drop in there before we wrap up?
For sure. I just want to zoom out a little bit and take a slightly bigger picture. India is the most competitive telecom market in the world. We have the lowest data rates and that sort of thing. The same problems that India faces with its connectivity is shared by other BRICS countries, other developing nations. If this model works in India, and it looks like it does, it's doing well, this is something that we believe that you can scale to over 1 billion people worldwide, because there are still something like 2.5 billion people across the planet that don't even have basic connectivity as yet. And as we evolve and firm up this model and battle test it here in the hardest conditions possible, we think that this is something that will dramatically scale globally.
Dang. Okay. So India, this is a great, great thing to take away, is that India is just the test market and this can be a worldwide network. That's pretty exciting.
Absolutely.
Cool. Ripping, dude. Well, thanks so much for your time. I know you got to get back to work. I know it's late there. Thanks for making a little slot for us and coming on and talking to folks about Wi-Fi Daba.
Thanks so much. And giant fan of the show.